Springs, Dave of the Desert, so proud to bring you my next episode on
the Evaro Brothers.
Jimmy and Jerry. I've known these guys for, God, at least 10 years now. I've been coming to Sammy G's. They play on Thursday, Friday, and Saturday night. They bring so much joy to so many people in the desert. They're from the desert. They've been playing music together for years. Jimmy and Jerry, both really accomplished musicians and singers. They have amazing harmonies. Bongos, guitar, they create this wall of sound that's just wonderful, and people dance, and really they bring so much joy, so I'm proud, as my friends, to bring you my next episode on
the Evaro Brothers
at Sammy G's right behind me. They play again Thursday through Saturday night in this Italian restaurant, this sTuscangrille, and they are wonderful people. So let's go meet Jimmy and Jerry
Evaro,
along with their cousin Shirley, who plays sometimes as well. They let people sing, express themselves as well. They're so welcoming. They're always in a good mood. They bring it all the time. They've been playing for years, but every time you see them, it seems like you're seeing them for the first time. That's how good they are. So David of the Desert is proud, 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 proud to bring you my next episode on
the Evaro Brothers.
Let's go meet Jimmy and Jerry right now. Thank you.
I am here with the Evaro Brothers. Yeah, welcome, man. So good to see you guys.
I am thrilled that you finally sit down with me. I've seen these guys for years, and they are the first family of music in Palm Springs.
Yeah, we are known as the first Latino family of the desert. Mom and Dad came in about 1961, and we were like the first family that they hardly saw kids out here in the desert.
Uh-huh.
And Dad was working in a place called the Ivy Bowl in Imperial Valley. And the people that saw him, they actually made the wrong turn, and they went into the bowling alley area, and they were playing in there. And it's called the Ivy Bowl. Everybody knew it out there.
Really?
In
Imperial Valley?
Yeah, okay. Imperial Valley. And the couples were the DeSarnolds, were the name of the people that saw Dad.
Okay.
Loved them and heard them. In 1961, Dad moved everybody out here this way, and we started playing music.
We showed up there around the 70s. We literally grew up in the music store.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, really?
I mean, we had instruments all over the house. We had a piano in the corner and drums and guitar and
that's
bass.
That's so awesome.
And Jimmy got his first it was a Quaker Oats.
I played on when I was there. Because my uncle would be playing, and I started cool. And I remember the Quaker Oats box, right? The dolphin one, right?
Yes, that's awesome.
Mom would finish them, and whenever I just asked her to give me the box, she knew. So she'd give me the boxes, and I'd go out. Remember the hangers, our clothes hangers?
Yeah.
With the, what is it, the cardboard?
Yeah.
The pants, right? So I pulled up, pop those off, and I'd break them in half, and they were the sticks.
Yeah.
Oh, that's awesome.
That's how Jim was real young.
Because we had a lot of influence with my uncles. And, you know, and when you're younger, you want to try to be that close.
Absolutely.
You know,
one thing I noticed, speaking of play, is you guys really not only play for yourselves, but the people that watch you, but you encourage people to come up there and sing, right?
Sure. So you want to get to Sammy's and, like, being home, you know, you just want to have everybody, like, family, you know? We want to get that kind of feel that they know they could, you know, they could shout anything out, you know, as long as it's, you know. Yeah.
We really like to make it a party atmosphere.
I agree.
We feed off the people, the energy. Yes. Sometimes you melt and just groove because you know the songs and you mix it up.
Right.
But it's really just the joy of playing and being able to people enjoy that.
When you're doing something you love, I mean, you cannot not enjoy it. I mean, we love playing music. We love singing. We love getting the audience going on and the feedback. And, you know, McCartney and the Rolling Stones, they're still gigging at these big...
I know,
arenas will never be up here, but it's almost the same deal, the same feeling.
I agree.
We love playing in our little hometown.
Speaking of up here, I know Jerry was invited to play with War, to go on tour
or something like that. Yeah, Jimmy
and said they turned it down to be here. Is that what happened?
It was more of taking care of my father,
okay.
my mother, and my boy going to school. Okay. The honor of that, being asked to do that, was just amazing.
What year was that? When did that happen?
That was about five, six years.
Really?
Six years
to go on tour with
him? War came inside of Sammy G's band. And they loved Jimmy. They needed a conga player, a percussionist, because they were having some issues with their conga player. He's going through a terrible divorce or something. But Jimmy was asked to go on the road with them.
Gerald, we're on our way out from leaving Dunegag in Texas, and halfway there, we get the call that they wanted to work with me.
It's pretty amazing.
To do it, yeah, and it was great.
But,
it was really good because...
But you couldn't leave your brother behind?
No,
yeah,
well, Jerry,
felt bad, Jerry.
Yeah, it was Jerry,
was a sad story.
You don't even, when that happens, you don't even know what to think. What's going on with your life? What's happening? How long will that last? We got to talk to these guys first because you don't know how long this.
I agree.
Well, Jim, it's only a couple of gigs or whatever. Who knows, right?
Yeah, good for
you. But they wanted to keep it going.
Yeah.
And it was really great. We had a lot of opportunity to play with big stars because even Jack Jones. Remember, Jerry wanted me to do the 50th anniversary?
Yeah, the anniversary at the McCollum
Theater. Me and Jerry walking out.
Jack Jones called Jimmy because they needed a percussionist. Percussionists, I tell you, they get these nice little gigs and they get the calls. And especially as you're as good as Jimmy. I think me being his brother I'm not just saying this. I think Jimmy's one of the best conga players in this I don't know how far you want to take it. But,
I agree.
You know, and those roots are all coming from, like, I go back to Jerry. Amazing. Jerry was my go-to guy. Jerry, what do you think? What do you think? Do I sound, bro, you sound good. I like that. Keep working on it. Keep doing it.
Right.
You know, and all of that is in me. Jerry, overall, as an entertainer, oh my gosh.
He
was my mentor.
Started singing at a pretty young age, but he didn't really get serious till he was about 16.
Yeah,
and
really.
He was listening to Peter Frampton. And
Jerry comes in the door and goes, Jim, he snuck in on me. She had his on the other side of the door in my room, and he just...
And he's singing,
I'm in you.
I mean,
I don't care where I go when I'm with you.
It was a slow kind of groove for Frampton on the radio, and it was a big hit.
Uh-huh.
And I heard Jimmy singing on it going, bro, you gotta... I learned that song on the piano, and Jimmy started singing it, and it was one of the first songs to get him out there to sing, and it was fun, just us starting to harmonize together.
Jerry kind of pruning me like a tree, you know, but Jim, do that. But Jerry was always the one I always could have, because I'm a guy, and I'm younger, so you're going for the guy, not the girl.
Yeah, you always had that little, that older
and Jerry
brother
was,
thing.
But everything we did in our lives, because we really depended on each other when we moved a lot with my father.
You know, I went to 13 different elementary schools
from the
first grade to the sixth grade, and we were like the new kids every two or three times a year. So we would just, like, congregate, because we didn't know anybody in the school, and we were just always...
We depended on each other,
and just kind of did music and was singing, and
And the music was always there.
Some of the schools went, hey, the Evaros, they sing. And they were asking us to go up and do some songs in the classrooms and stuff like that.
Right, young. Yeah.
So it was cool how that all, you know, we look back at it now and it was so, you know, it was just so, one of those things where we're, as kids, yeah. You know, you don't think about.
Kind of more
organic. It was always there.
It was always there for us.
It was always there, and we were told by our dads because they were doing it already and making a living that way with us. So we knew if we were what they told us, we're on the right track. As a matter of fact, Dave, our first job we ever did were, I don't know if I got paid, I can't remember, but it was at the El Mirador Hotel, which is now the Desert Regional Hospital.
Right, yes. Yeah.
It, what's going on right now, and it will always be, the people are everything to us. That's what keeps us alive in our living.
If it's, I agree.
If it's for the people, you don't have nothing. And that goes with everything in life, the way the world turns.
I agree.
I don't call them fans because I think that's like a...
Oh, I've known you guys for years.
You know, people like to say, oh, my fans... We don't... No, they're our friends. Not. You know, we just love the fact when they come here, they have a great time. Even people from out of town will come here. They had a bum weekend, and then they find out, well, there's a band at Sammy G's, the Evaro Brothers. Go check them out. And we made their night. And then they come up to us and go, you guys not only made our night, you made our whole weekend. It started off at the airport where we couldn't get a rental car or something like that.
Exactly.
And that made our weekend.
So that makes us feel good more than anything.
I agree. Now, these guys, you've been at Sammy G's for how long?
God, 13 years.
13 years. And people can see you Thursday through Saturday. I know
Thursday
that.
Thursday through Saturday.
Because I've been coming like the years.
Yeah, brother. I'll see you.
And then you guys just don't do this. I know you do other gigs. Go to Vegas sometimes. You guys do like other charity gigs.
That's it.
Exactly.
But I think the bottom line is just keep enjoying what you do. You get the desire, you feel it.
And you'll do it well. And you'll do it well.
You'll do it well because you want to give that to people. And I think it's a God.
I
just
agree.
Puts it on the table for you.
Anybody wants to come on down to see the Evaro Brothers, I want to thank you guys for the this interview and this show. We'll be posted
Dave,
soon.
Thank you. We love you, brother.
Love you so much.
Love you too, man.
You got it, brother.
Awesome.
Right on, Dave.
All right. Look, I'll be in there in a little bit. So,
okay. All right, Dave.
Guys, for watching this episode, please subscribe to my channel at David of the Desert, and a special warm thanks to Jerry and Jimmy for allowing me to film them and capture their glory in this episode. And thanks for watching, and please hit the like button, and more good stuff to come from David of the Desert live at Sammy G's, where again you can see the Evaro Brothers on Thursday through Saturday, and they are wonderful people. Come and check them out. Thanks for watching.